Okay, we've built this composition. When we press run, it creates this window and counts upon it. Now, let's learn some more about Vue by walking through a little bit of live coding. Live coding means modifying your composition while it's running. This can be handy, for example, if you want to see what you're building while you're building it, or if you're creating live visuals at a show and want to mix it up. The first thing we'll look at is Show Events mode, which we can initiate by clicking the button here. Now we can see our composition pulsing every 1 second. Let's slow it down a little bit. I'll just fire periodically to fire an event every 2 seconds. We've talked about how events can flow in a composition, and now we can actually see what's happening. Every time Fire Periodically's trigger port expands, an event is being fired outward. And every time a node becomes lit up with color, those nodes are executing their function. So every 2 seconds, a singular event is flowing from Fire Periodically through all of these nodes to produce the count you see here. The next thing we'll look at is port popovers. Anytime a composition is running, we can click on a port and get all the current information from that port. For example, we can click on the output port of count and see that the data type is a real number, when the last event passed through, and the current value. We can click on the layer output port and see that our data is now converted to a layer, the current value, and everything about the font and the position of our text. If you decide that there is information that you'd really like to keep track of, you can simply click on a popover and create an independent window to view as you'd like. You probably noticed that the requested frame output port of Render Layers to Window seems to be pulsing faster than the rest. Let's take a look. If we look at the last event line, we can see that it's outputting approximately 60 events every second. If we look at our documentation, we can read that this port fires an event every time my laptop display is ready to display a new frame, which is happening about 60 times per second. To make smooth animations, you'll typically want to use the events from requested frame to drive your composition. Also, this port outputs the time in seconds as its data, which you can use to make animations that change over time. Since we're aware of how our events are flowing, I'll go ahead and hide events mode. The next thing I'd like to do is insert a background image. To do this, I'm going to follow the same progression that we did for our count. We'll start with an event, then we'll create what we want, then we'll turn it into a layer and insert it into our composition. Since my background isn't going to change, like our count is changing every 2 seconds, I'll only want to use one event to create it, instead of processing the same background over and over again every 2 seconds. When building compositions, it's good practice to be as efficient as possible by only processing what you need to. By having complete control of events, you have complete control of what you process. So instead of using fire periodically, I'll put fire on start onto the canvas. Now that we have our event, I'm going to choose an image for our background. I'll take an image from my desktop of some hands counting, and I'll drag and drop it into our composition. When you drop an image onto the canvas, Vue automatically creates the appropriate node to retrieve it. Now I'll take our singular event and connect it to the refresh port of fetch image. When fetch image receives the event, it will retrieve this image. Since we want to turn this image into a layer that we can stack our counting layer on top of, I'll go to the node library and type make layer. I'm going to choose make scaled layer because this node will give us the ability to resize the layer if need be. Now we'll take our image plus our event and link it to the image import of make scaled layer. Next, we'll take our new layer. And since we want this to be our background layer, I'm going to lay it down first by putting it in the first position. Then I'll take the layer of our count and stack it in front by putting it in the second position. Now our background layer is ready to go. We just need to send an event through it. Since our composition is already running, I'll just go ahead and right-click our trigger port and fire an event. And there's our background layer. All right, to conclude, let's have just a little fun. And I'll walk you through some easy live coding choices for this composition. I'll speed up our count. I'll count backwards by fives. I'll increase our text size. I'll change the color to baby blue. I'll bring the location of our text downward. And let's do something with our requested frame port. Remember, we have an event coming out of here about 60 times per second, with a value that's increasing about once every second. And we can use this stream of events and stream of values to make smooth animations. So let's feed this output into our rotation port of our layer. And here we see that it starts to rotate very slowly. So I'll go to the node library and find a multiply node. Put it on the canvas, and I'll bring our value into it, and I'll multiply our value by 100. And I'll send it back to the rotation. And awesome. All right, that's enough for now. Thanks so much for checking out our quick start videos. To keep learning, your most valuable resources are Vuo's growing number of built-in example compositions, video tutorials, and the manual. Thanks for choosing Vuo, and happy creating.